we want to first look at these little things, which is from a viewer. Thank you, Austin. And it's from the Apollo spacecraft. And Mike, you have been working on it.
Yeah.
And finding what it is.
Yep.
What is it?
They're lunar module caution lamps. These are used for the rendezvous radar no-track light, and also for several ECS caution lamps, about quantities and things like that.
And I never noticed them because they look gray. They look like a push button. Can you hold them for me so
yeah.
I can do a close up on it?
Yeah, they're gray cylinders that kind of
look like buttons. So I never noticed them until Austin told me about them.
Mm-hmm.
And you didn't know either. You hadn't noticed them either.
Nope.
They're just lamps.
Lamp test diode.
Yeah, they have an integrated lamp test diode. There's three pins on the back here. We'll show you the schematics. So there is the rendezvous radar no track light here. There's several of them.
Mm-hmm.
CO2, H2O set.
Oh, it's where something goes wrong, basically.
Yeah, they're all caution lamps.
And we don't find them in the command module, right? I don't think I ever saw one of these.
I don't think so. They have Grumman specification numbers on them, so they might just be a lunar module thing.
All right.
Their part number is LSC350-80610-02. And if we look at the Grumman schematics for the radar section, this is a part list. So you can see no track caution light, LSC350-80610-02.
Right.
So this is, part number matches. This says it should have a yellow lens.
Mm-hmm.
They came in red too, I think.
Mm-hmm.
This is sort of systems level how they're wired up.
Mm-hmm.
There's a caution warning DC dimmer circuit in the lighting control assembly that dims from 2 to 5 volts. So these lights have 5 volts on their power pin always. When the subsystem wants to light the caution lamp, it grounds pin 2.
The other side.
And then these diodes are built in to the switch, or to the light, and go to the lamp test.
Yeah, lamp test. I discovered on my own that you needed a diode.
Yeah.
Because if not, you are going to short them all together, and when you light one, you light all of them. So
yeah.
Lamp test needs an extra diode. So that's the third pin, is the one
right.
That has the diode to it.
And this is the elementary functional diagrams for the lunar module that show all the things in more detail. So you can see the pin 1, 2, and 3 for the light.
Very cool. Right here. Let's light it up.
Yeah, let's do it. 1, power, 2, ground. Alright.
Yeah, okay. So I have it hooked up to the power supply. I've already pre-adjusted it. So that's 0 volt. That's 2.5. Fairly dim. And that's 5 volts. Ooh.
It's very orange.
It's very eerily even. Although in the camera it doesn't look like that. To the eye.
Yeah, to the eye, it's very orange.
Yeah,
and very flat.
It doesn't look like an incandescent bulb at all.
Mm-hmm.
Very flat. And it has a super wide view angle, too. So it's really meant to be visible from an oblique angle.
Mm-hmm.
Very uniform, like a bit, you can't tell the depth on it, right, when things
right.
are so uniform. So, wow, beautiful indicator. We didn't even know it existed. Thank you, Austin.
Yeah, Rachel. Thank you.
We'll use it for something. Oh, ah. It's really beautiful in the dark.
Yeah, it is. I'll take a picture of it with the lights on. See if that...
So that's... You want that at full blast? That's it for our lighthearted Friend Lab inspired video. As you can tell, we get easily entertained by over-engineered stuff that glows or clicks. And we'd like to thank our viewers and Patreons for the many unique items they keep donating to the channel. Thanks again, Austin, and see you in the next episode.